Hello everybody, welcome to a new tutorial with PSD Box. I'm Andrei, and it's been a long time since I published my last free tutorial here on YouTube and on my website. And truth is that I had some problems with my website, some personal problems as well, and I couldn't publish new tutorials or even read my emails, so I apologize for that. I'm back into business. The premium website and everything is now under one website, which is psdbox.com, because people had lots of problems switching to websites, and I understand it. Now everything is into one place and problem solved. Okay, let's go with today's tutorial. What I want to show you today is how to use the lab color mode to make color corrections on an image, and also how to create selective sharpening in Photoshop. Of course, what I'm going to show you today can be done in different ways, and also maybe in RGB color space, but I want to show you how you can do it in the lab color mode. So I got this image from unsplash.com. You can see I have the link over here. If you're watching this from YouTube, you will find the link on the video description if you want to use exactly the same image, but you can use any image. This is just for demonstration purpose. It works on any image. And if you're watching this from the website, you'll find the link on the web page as well. So let's get started with this. We're going to start with the sharpening, because if we start with the color correction and then we sharpen the image, if you want to make any kind of change on the color correction, we have to throw away the sharpening, make the correction, and then sharpen it again. So we're going to start work on the sharpening. So the first thing we want to do is go to image, mode, and choose lab color. You will see that nothing happens except that flicker over there, which indicates that Photoshop switched to lab color space. The image is exactly the same, but the only changes that you will see is, for example, here on the blend modes menu, you will see that some of the blend modes are not available in this color space, which is normal. Also, if you go to channels, you will see that instead of having RGB for red, green, and blue, we have lightness, we have channel A and channel B. We're going to talk about what each of these layers mean a little later on when we're going to make the color correction. But first, let's work on the sharpening, as I said. So select the lab channel, which is the composite. Select any of the selection tools. I use the rectangular marquee tool. Press Control Command A to select the entire canvas and go to Edit, Copy, Merge. So press Shift Command C or Shift Control C on a PC. This will copy the whole thing. Now we have to create a new channel by clicking this new channel icon, and we're gonna paste that here with Control V or Command V. You will see that it's gonna paste it on black and white, which is normal because alpha channels do not have color information, or at least it's not gonna show it on color, in color. So here what we have is an equivalent in black and white of each of the colors that we have here on the LAB layer. You're gonna see that it's not the same as the lightness. Okay, so if you choose lightness and then go to alpha 1, you will see that alpha 1 is darker, because here the only thing that we did is just convert those colors into black and white, while the lightness only holds information about the light and shadows, not the color. So it's not a color conversion, it's just light information. Okay, now we have alpha 1, and this is the layer that we're going to use to sharpen our image. We're going to go to filter, sharpen, stylize, and choose fine edges. As I said, we're going to sharpen the edges of the image, but not only the edges, because you can see that we have some of the dark bits there as well. This dark parts of the image will be the ones that will be sharpened. We're going to convert this into a mask, so everything that is black will be the parts that are that will be selected and sharpened. So not really a mask, because on a mask the white parts gets the effect that we're applying. In this case it's the opposite. Now we want a little more contrast. So I'm going to press Ctrl Command M to open the curves, and I'm going to move the black point somewhere around here. The more you move it to the right, the more black area you get. and that means more of the image will be sharpened. If you only want to sharpen the edges, you should move the white point as well to this, to the left. And you can see that now we got rid of all of the black bits in between and only the highest contrast bits of the image are selected. We don't want to have that, it's too extreme. So I'm going to put this somewhere around there and the blacks somewhere around here. Now, this depends on each image because each image has its own contrast and it works like that. So I'm going to have it somewhere there because I want inner parts of the image to be sharpened as well. So not only the edges, because it's going to look weird. Okay, so I'm going to press OK. And now, because some parts of the edges are too sharp, the transition between black and white is too sharp, I want to blur that slightly, because if I'm to sharpen this, it's going to have a really sharp effect over here, and then we have a really unsharpened effect here, so the transition is not going to be really that good. So I'm going to go to Filter, Blur, and I'm going to choose the Gaussian Blur. Now, we don't need much of a blur here, just one pixel. You can see that one, or if you have a really high resolution image, maybe two, but not more than that. Something like that, just to soften a little bit the edges. Remember, this is not going to affect how sharp the image is going to be. The sharpening has nothing to do with this blur. This is just to the transition between the sharpened area and the less sharp areas of the image, okay? I don't know if I explained myself, but you're going to see that in just a second. Now, we have this layer ready. I'm going to double click here to change the name, and I'm going to name this Edges. Press Enter, and I'm going to select the Lab channel to go back to the Composite and go back to Layers. Now, this channel is there alone. We're going to use it right now. I'm going to create a copy of my image, and I'm going to name this Sharp. With Control Command J, you can create copies. And now I'm going to go to Select, Load Selection, and from the channel, I'm going to select that channel that I just created, Edges, and click OK. You can see now my selection is loaded. Now, everything that you see is selected is the areas that we're going to sharpen. You can see that we only have marching ends around here, but actually, more of the image is selected, just that it's not visible. Okay, so remember we had some dark bits around here as well, but they are so small and semi-transparent that the marching ends are not created, okay? Now, these marching ends are bothering me because if I were to apply the sharpening filter here, I'm not going to see the effects. I'm going to hide them. How you do that? With Control or Command H. If this is the first time you do this, it's going to ask you if you want to hide Photoshop or if you want to hide the extras or guides or whatever. Choose hide guides or hide extras instead of hiding Photoshop. And this will make the marching end stay go away, but the selection is still active. With the selection active, I'm going to go to Filter, Sharpen, and I'm going to choose... I usually like to use the Unsharp Mask, but you can use any of the filters here. Make sure you go to 100% by pressing Command 1 or Control 1 on your keyboard to see the image on the real size. Threshold, we're going to set it to 0 because we already have our areas well selected. And the radius really depends on the size of your image. If you go too high, you're going to start to see halos and really strange stuff, which we don't want. About 1 for this canvas size. And of course, the amount really depends on your image. Try to just move around the image with the space bar. You can click and look through the image to see how the image gets sharpened. I like this area over here to assess my sharpening effect because we have highlights, we have shadows, we have small details around here, we have medium details, we have edges. So it's a good point to assess our effect. I'm going to increase the amount a little more and probably the radius slightly more. I don't know if you can see it on the video, but if I deactivate and reactivate it, you can see how the effect looks like. It's harder on the edges because that's what we wanted, but we also sharpen the inner parts of the object, as you can see right over here on these areas. Take a look. Okay, now I'm gonna click OK and we're done with the sharpening. Let's move on with the color correction. For that, I'm gonna use a curves adjustment. You can use levels as well. And since I had my selection active, I forgot to deselect by pressing Control Command D. I'm gonna fill this with white because I know I don't need the mask here. Here on the curves, you will see that we have exactly the same channels. Lightness, A and B. Now, what's the A and what's the B? Channel A contains the information for red and green. And in fact, if you move this line down, you will see that you add green on the image. If you move it up, you add red or magenta. Actually, I think it's cyan and magenta. And on the B, we have blue and we have yellow. And this is all we need to remove color casts from our image. Now, let's start with the A. The difficult part here is judging what kind of color cast your image has. Now, I think there are more advanced ways of analyzing your image, but for this tutorial, I'm just gonna do it by eye. I don't know if you can use this these eyedropper tools to kinda change how the image gets corrected. I like to use it, I like to make this manually. I know this has some yellow cast on it because I see it here on the whites. Actually, you can, I think you can use the information or the from window. If you go to, if you check the info here from the window, choose info, and when you move across an image, you will start to see the image here on CMYK. For example, yellow, you see have a big deal of yellow, 20%, 38%, and it's kind of too much. But let's do it the easy way. Let's go to the B channel because we need to take away some of the yellow. So I'm gonna drag this down a little bit. And actually, I'm gonna do it more on the whites than on the shadows. So I'm gonna drag this down like so, and probably leave this about there. A little more right over there. And on the A channel, you can add a little more green on some parts of the image, maybe right over there, a little more red over there. Back to the B, probably add more blue to the shadows. Really quickly, just to show you how you can tweak the images here, okay? On the lightness channel, what you can do is increase the lightness, actually the contrast of the image, without affecting the colors, because we have no color information on this channel. So you can darken the image, you can increase the contrast a little bit, like so, okay? And that's pretty much it. That's the color correction. Really quick, really basic. It's not something that's really advanced, but you can correct your images like this. Now, let me show you how the image looked without using the curves, before and after. We have more contrast, and you can see that yellow here on the white parts and the overall image is now gone. Also, on the greens are looking more green now, not that yellowish, okay? And that's how it looks like. Let me show the original image. This is what we started with, and this is what we have. I'm gonna zoom it in 100% so you can also see the sharpening. For example, on this area, before and after, I think it looks way better, especially right over here. Take a look. Take a look at this area as well, before and after. Okay, so this is how you can use the lab color mode to make color corrections and sharpening your images. I hope you liked this tutorial. If you did, if it's the first time you see my channel, make sure you subscribe and also visit my website, psdbox.com. You have lots of Photoshop tutorials there, you have playlists, you have resources and all kinds of design stuff there that you may like. So thanks for watching and see you next time.